today I will be going through all the benches in Hollow Knight, including the ones added through the bench random mod, and I'll be ranking each bench on a couple of different criteria. Usefulness, placement, aesthetic, just overall vibes of the bench, but also how useful it is in a rando to get. So, you know, the benches that are more centralized lead to more checks, things like that will have higher rankings. So that's what we're going to be doing first. There are 154 benches to go through. I'll explain most of my thoughts. Our first bench is the Abyss Workshop Bench. This bench is down in Ancient Basin in the Abyss, all the way to the right, near where we get Shade Cloak. And this one is locked behind a shade wall or shade gate. And there's only one other check in this room besides the bench itself, and it's the Void Tendrils check. So it doesn't give us a whole lot of access unless we have Shade Cloak, which is a pretty late game ability. But it does give us access behind a shade gate. Also, it's a pretty cool location to have a bench. Not very useful. You're probably not coming back here very often. So I'm gonna go ahead and put it in B. It's when I get this bench, I'm like, cool, I'm glad I got this. All right, the next bench is Acid Sluice. This is another bench that was added by the Bench Rando mod. This one is in a really weird location. It's positioned above an acid pool, and it's sort of useful if you have wings or dash or claw, but it doesn't really give you a whole lot of access to anything. You know, maybe a couple checks in Isma's Grove area to the left of Isma's Grove. It doesn't give you access to Isma's Grove unless you have the required checks. So I'm gonna go ahead and put it in D. I do not enjoy getting this bench. It's not one I'm like, oh yes, I really wanted this. Also, I tend to forget about it. Next one is Acid Sluice West. This one is in the Crystal Dash area to the left of Isma's, which is the intended entrance into Isma's. Just like Acid Sluice East, it doesn't stand out. If you have wings or claw and dash, it'll help you get into waterways, but for the most part, you know, low level materials, you don't get much from it. So I'll put it in D as well. Next up is Ancestral Mound Bench. This is our first bench that was in the vanilla game. However, considering Rando, it's kind of an interesting bench. It's a bit centralized in Crossroads, and it can be very helpful if you have Transition Rando on. Most benches that are behind doors can be helpful in that way. This bench is it's a good bench to have. However, thinking back on all my bench randos, I don't use it all that much. It's really helpful to come back to it if you have to do the dream route in Ancestral Mound, but it's not like the best Crossroads bench to get. It's a couple transitions, and if Crossroads becomes infected, you can only get to it from one direction. So I'm actually gonna put it in B as well. Next up is Ancient Nest Bench. So Ancient Nest Bench is another bench that I often forget about existing. I actually forget to check it quite often. So this is in the Sharp Shadow Room to the left, down a little side hall that like literally exists for no reason in vanilla game. So this bench sits in between the Deep Nest Hot Springs bench and the Tram bench, the lower Tram bench. So if you don't have either of those, this one can be decent. But it's not like my favorite to get. It's forgettable. It doesn't have a whole lot of access. It doesn't give you really anything, especially if you don't have any, if you don't have claw. You need claw to get from this bench anywhere. So I'm gonna go ahead and put this one in C. It can replace other benches if need be, but overall it's not super helpful. All right, our next bench is the Archives bench. This one's an automatic A. It's just an excellent bench. It helps if you die to Umu. It gets you out of Archives, which gets you full access to Fog Canyon, because it puts you on the left and the right of that breakable wall, or on the right of that breakable hall so you can get to the left. It's a good centralized bench for that area. It's a very good bench. The next bench is the Balder Cavern bench. So this is in the room to the right of Bench Fly King, in the room where Balder Shell is. It's a decent bench, I would say. It gets you access, well, mostly just to Green Path if you don't have Dash or Wings. If you have Dash, Wings, Claw, you can get up to cliffs with it, but usually by that time you have other stuff up there. I do remember some randos where this bench was actually something I used a lot, especially to get to Green Path. It can help if you don't have an upper Green Path bench, either like the one in Toll or the one in the Stag Station. So overall, it's a decent bench. It's centralized between two different areas. So it gets you some access if you have the right abilities. So I'll put it in B. Next up is Bardoon's bench. This bench is placed at the top of Edge-ish, right next to Bardoon. Aesthetically, this bench is amazing. It's awesome. I love Bardoon so much. However, it doesn't give a whole lot of checks. It's just kind of up there by Bardoon, and it's kind of trapping you with a bunch of primal aspids. Getting to this bench, you need claw and wings. Overall, though, it's not a bench I use a lot. It never has been. I usually just visit it for a check, and then I'll use any other edge bench. If I don't have camp bench or the hornet bench that's sometimes there, or Coliseum bench, or any of the benches in the large edge room, I don't use this. But it does have Bardoon, so obviously it's an A. The next one needs no discussion. This is Bardoon's butt bench, or Bardoon's tail, as the mod likes to call it. But we all know it's Bardoon's butt. So this is on Mac S tier. It gives you immediate access to the butt. And who doesn't want access to butt? All right, the next bench is Basin Hub bench. So this bench gets placed in the middle of the basin room, the large basin room, at the top. And it is probably one of my favorite benches. It gets you access to pretty much all of basin, unless you have, except for, White Palace and Abyss. But it's a very centralized. I use this bench a lot, especially if I don't have lower tram bench. Because it is at the top of the room, it gets you access to the fountain. So even if you don't have claw or wings, you can get out of this room no matter what from this bench. It's one of my favorites. So I'm actually gonna put this one up in S tier as well. It's a very good bench. Next bench is the Basin Toll bench. This one is also a very good bench. A lot of the basin benches are very good. Obviously this one is a vanilla bench. It doesn't get you access unless you have the right skills. So C dash or wings. And you have to pay money for it, but also if you just get the bench check, you don't have to pay the money. But this is a good alternative to the basin hub bench. I use this one a lot whenever I need to go to Abyss or to the Stag Station if there isn't a bench there. So I'm going to put this one in A. It's a good bench. All right, next up is the Beast Den bench. This is the real one that you get after getting trapped up in Beast Den. So getting this one before you enter Beast Den is pretty good. It gets you a few checks. It obviously gets you access to Beast Den without having to go through the trap. However, you do need claw to get up. It's just a good safe bench. It isn't used a whole lot. However, Beast Den has a lot of checks. So it's good to come. I often find myself using this one just to come back to the area. Distant Village doesn't have a whole lot of benches in it, and some of the ones that it does have are pretty bad. So this is a good bench. I would put it in B. Put it at top of B. All right, next bench is Black Egg Temple. Without a doubt, S tier bench. It's the Black Egg Temple bench. If you get this one, so you can't actually pick up this bench in a rando. It's locked behind checks. You cannot get to it unless you have all three dreamers. However, it is by far the best bench to have if you are in a race. If you get three dreamers and you don't have, you know, Void Heart, you sit at this bench, and as soon as you find Void Heart, you're done. You can just warp here and go. It's also the bench that saves you if you are like bad at the game. So I think it's a top tier bench. The next bench is the Blasted Plains bench. This is the one that's in cliffs all the way to the left at the bottom. I don't get this bench super often, and I definitely don't use it too often. So there are two possible benches in cliffs in that room. This one and the one at the top. This is a bench that's at the bottom of a room you are meant to climb. So if in a rando you don't have wings or claw, this bench is practically useless. It gets you like two checks. So I would say it's a pretty meh bench. I'll put it in D. Next up is Bretta bench. Now Bretta bench is an F tier bench. Who cares about Bretta? It's garbage. to be fair to Bretta's bench, it is a vanilla bench and probably the best bench for Mantis Village if you don't have bench rando on. So I will say that. But however, it is Bretta's bench, so it's garbage. Next up is the camp bench, the one in Edge. This is another vanilla bench, base game. I would say this bench is average. It's really only useful for Hornet 2 fight or Hornet Sentinel. It's pretty decent if you don't have any other benches in Edge, but it is far to the right. And again, you have to fight through like three aspects just to get out of there. It is, however, the closest bench to the best grub, Pierogi. That should be taken into consideration. I would say this is a C tier bench. C for camp. Next up is Canyon Depths. This is by far one of my favorite benches to get. It gets you access to all of Fog Canyon. So any bench that's on the right of the Fog Canyon breakable wall, to the left of Archives, gets you access to that entire area. It gives you safety in a very dangerous area. It's a good bench. However, if you do not have claw or wings, you cannot get to this bench from below. It is just out of reach, which makes it infuriating. So I'll say it's a low A tier, not an S tier, because of that little infuriation. Other than that, it's a great bench. Next bench is the Canyon's End bench. This is the bench that's on the left side of the Fog Canyon Acids skip room. If you do any percent, I don't actually know what to call that room. The Queen's Gardens Acid room, you know, with the big thorns over the acid pool. It gets you access to Queen's Gardens a bit, the lower Queen's Gardens. I honestly forget this one exists quite a lot. I forget to check it. It's not my favorite bench to get, but it can be useful if you don't have much in Queen's Gardens. You need claw or wings to get out of the room to the left, go up. You need claw or wings to get out of the Petra Arena area. So it gives you some stuff, but overall it doesn't, I'm not excited about this bench, so C tier. Next bench is the Crusher Refuge bench. This is in the Upper Crushers in Peak. It's a very centralized location. Arguably maybe a little dangerous, but it's the Crushers. Who struggles with Crushers? I use this bench a lot. It's a good bench. It's a very reliable bench, so A tier. Because Peak is a very claw heavy room, the higher up the bench, the better it is. All right, the next one is the city entrance bench. So this is in the room to the right of Fungal Waste, the acid bridge room. It's just kind of there. Honestly, I didn't know this bench existed for quite a long time. This bench is basically equivalent of having a city crest, and that's it. It doesn't help you get past up into storerooms. It doesn't help you get to right side city. It's kind of meh. I'll cut it in C. The next one is City Fountain Bench. This is in the City Fountain Room to the left of the fountain. Kind of the same gripes with it as the City Entrance Bench. It really only gives you access to left side city, which is the city crest area. However, this is a great bench for limb easy access. So I think that puts it a step above the entrance bench. It's also just like a fun location for a bench to be. Very centralized, so if you do have access to right side city, it definitely gets you closer than entrance does. And then also it gets you to water, it doesn't get you to waterways, but quick access to waterways if you don't have a bench down there. So I would put this in B. Next up is our first Quirrell bench. This is the vanilla one in city. And again, same gripes as city entrance. It just gives you access to left side. It isn't super helpful otherwise, but obviously it has Quirrell. So A tier. Honestly, I prefer city fountain over this one, but it has Quirrell, so we'll put it in A. Next bench is the city storerooms bench. Being a bench in a stag is automatically bumping you up A tier. It's bumping you up A tier. Stag benches are super important in a rando. I love them a lot. I hate randos with like no stag benches. It's very annoying. This gives you a bit more access to city than the previous benches so far. So I think it's an A tier bench. I definitely want this one a lot. The next one is the City Toll Bench. This was the one outside of Sanctum. It's a decent bench, centralized upwards. Decent access to Sanctum if you have an upwards movement. Gets you access to storerooms. You can't actually go far down because of the levers. But it's a reliable bench. Again, it costs money. I'll go ahead and put this one in B. The next bench is the Cliffs Overhang Bench. Now, when I was talking about the Blasted Plains bench, I referenced this bench. This bench is at the top of that room, and it is by far one of the best benches to get for that area for cliffs. If you don't have claw or wings, you can just warp to this bench and just keep falling down, getting every single check in that room, and just go back up if you miss one. You just keep doing that. And then also, it gives you access to the rest of cliffs. So over to Gorb, Mato, and then down into King's Pass. It is probably one of my favorite benches to get in a rando. It's an S tier bench. The next bench is Cloth's Ambush Bench. This is in the room where you first find Cloth, where she's, you know, hiding underground and she pops up to the left of Elder Who and above Mantis Village. It's a good, reliable bench. It's pretty centralized, and any bench that helps you get to Who faster is a good bench, because everyone forgets Who. Elder Who is just very forgettable, and then you're like, oh wait, I'm gonna go fight this dude. Where's my closest bench? And because Fungal Waste is a very early game area, you can get to a lot of places with this bench. My only gripe with it is that it's so far to the right that you kind of miss the stuff on the left. But overall, it's a great bench. I'll put it in B. Next up is Coliseum Bench. This is a trash bench. This is a joke bench. It's useless. It's garbage. It's a terrible bench. Don't use it. Who dies in Coliseum anyways? I hate getting this bench early on because you need claw. You definitely need claw to get out of there if you do not have the modded platforms in. It has no real purpose other than, like, I don't know, putting on charms for a Coliseum. But again, only noobs do that, so... Trash bench. I don't even want to talk about Pale Lurker. Okay, so the next bench is the Crossroads Elevator Bench. This is in the on the left side of the room to the right of the elevator. It's an okay bench. Honestly, I hate checking for it because it's a walk. You walk all the way over to the left to see if it's there, and then you walk all the way back if it isn't. It's not a helpful bench at all. I mean, at most, it'll get you pretty quick access to Salubra if you don't have Salubra's bench. And it'll help if you find elevator pass, and then you can get access to the room to the left of the elevator. Other than that, storerooms below, easier to get if you have a stag. It's not a very memorable bench. I'll put it in D. The next bench is the Crossroads Center Bench. And it's in this name. This is a very centralized bench. This is a great bench to get if you don't start out in Crossroads or don't have access to Crossroads early on. One of the ways I rank benches in Crossroads is how quickly I can get to Black Egg Temple. This one is a bit of a trek. It's actually, it's pretty decent. It takes, you have to go around to get to the Black Egg Temple from it. But if you don't have like Dirtmouth bench, this is a decent bench to have. But it's if you were playing a casual vanilla game, this bench would be immediately accessible, and you know, you'd use it a little bit. So I'd say it's C tier. It's average. The next bench is one of our hot springs benches. This is our Crossroads hot spring bench. Any bench in a hot springs room is kind of weird because it's a bench in a hot springs room. Like, why would I use the hot spring when I can just use the bench? And if you have bench rando on, you automatically get Saluba's blessing. So hot springs aren't really all that useful for gathering soul, because the bench will heal you and give you soul pretty quickly, actually. Its location is decent. It's centralized for Crossroads and Fungal Waste. So if you want to get to Fungal Waste pretty quickly and you don't have any benches there, this is a decent bench to have. I find I get this bench a lot, but if you need to explore Crossroads, this is not a bench I would want. It's bottom left. It gives you access to a lot of areas, but not quickly. So overall, it's a pretty average bench as well. I'll put it in C. The next bench is the Crossroads Stag Bench. This is a stag bench, so automatically better bench than most. This is a good bench to have if you need to go back to fight failed champion. It's decent access to Salubra, a little bit more annoying if Crossroads is infected. But like I said, it's a stag bench. So I would say this is actually probably a decent bench. I think A. The next bench is the Crown Ascent Bench. This bench is in Crown's Ascent in Peak. So Crown is the top where the Radiant Statue is. This is in the room. Well, this is in that same room right near the entrance. This is a great bench to have because in Peak, you want to be on top. If you don't have Claw, you can't do Peak. But if you have this bench, you can fall and get a lot of checks. So, and technically, this area requires wings as well. Most rando players I know can get here without wings. I think this is a very, very good bench to have. I'd say A, just because of its placement in Peak, the access it gives you, and you just warp to it and fall. Get you a lot of stuff. The next one is the Crips Bench. This is the one that's below the dive floor in Resting Grounds. I think this is a pretty solid bench. With Claw, you can get up to Resting Grounds and do all the Crips with it. I find myself going back to this one a lot. It's definitely preferable to the other bench that's in this area. So I'm gonna go ahead and put this one in B. All right, the next one is the Crystal Cavern Bench. So this is in that big Crystal Peak room below Ascent and to the right of like the main peak area. This is like a okay bench. Honestly, I don't enjoy getting it. Again, it's decent because it's high up. However, it's in a weird location. If you do not have dash, wings, or claw, it's a challenge to get away from this bench because there's a decent sized gap to the left of it. It is, I think it's doable, or you can do an enemy pogo if you can maneuver an enemy, but I do not like this bench that much. I'm gonna put it in D. All right, next bench is the Crystal Guardian Bench. Higher up than Refuge Bench. It has a boss on it, which isn't a problem. It's an easy boss to kill. It's centralized. It's a good bench. Helpful if you need to go back to fight Enraged Guardian. Easy access to some other checks. I would put this one in B. The next bench is the crystallized mound bench. So this one is interesting because it actually puts you below the dive floor. So if you have dash claw wings and don't have dive, you can do crystallized mound with this bench. Other than that, it's kind of meh. It's useful for getting to crystal mound when you need it. However, you can't immediately get out of crystal mound. If you want to leave crystal mound with this bench, you have to go all the way through it again, and it's not all that useful. And it'll immediately take you to resting grounds or the bottom of peak. And there are usually other benches and easier ways to get to where you need to go there. So I'm gonna put this one in, I'll put it in D. The next bench is the Dark Gardens bench. This is the bench that is right next to the transition between Queen's Gardens and Dark Deep Nest. If you are a seasoned randoer or speedrunner and you can do dark rooms, this is actually a pretty decent bench to get. It gets you access to Deep Nest pretty early and puts you at the top of that big room. I don't mind getting this bench. However, if you do not have claw, you cannot get the gardens from here. It's a good centralized bench in between two different areas, so it gives you access to different areas if you have the right equipment, being claw and lantern. It's more of a high level bench, so the more skilled you are at Hollow Knight, the easier this bench is to use. And for that, I'll put it in C. Next, you know what? It's D. I don't like it that much. The next bench is the Deep Nest Gate bench. So this is the bench that's to the left of the Mantis Lord's fight, which means that there's a giant ass door to the right of this bench if you get it early on. It does not give you access to Mantis Lords. It gets you access to Deep Nest if you have wings and or claw. You need claw to get to corner first check, but other than that, it's like an okay bench. I'm gonna actually put it in D too. It's not one I use a lot. Next bench is the Deep Nest Hot Spring bench. This bench is pretty good. I mean, it's lower Deep Nest, but it is to the right side, so it's in the lit part of Deep Nest. It gives you access to the tram if you need it, and obviously it has a hot spring in it, so it's like partially useful. It can be a challenging bench if you don't have vertical movement. It doesn't give you a whole lot. So I would say this is a C tier bench. All right, the next bench is the Deep Nest Maze bench. So this is actually in the same room, technically the same room as the Hot Springs bench, because it's all one room. This is at the top of the room though. I've gotten this bench maybe once in my year of playing. It doesn't come up all that often. I feel like it would actually be a pretty useful bench. It gets you access to lower Deep Nest if you have claw. If you don't have claw, you can go up all the way up to, well, not all the way up to Fungal, but you can go up a bit. Overall though, it's not a fantastic bench. I actually would prefer it less than the Hot Springs bench, so I'm putting it in D. The next bench is Defender's Repose. So this is the bench that is in the area, the dive area after Dung Defender. Getting this bench gets you one check, and it's the King's Idol to the right. If you do not have claw, you cannot get out. That's about it. Very rarely do you have to fight White Defender in a rando, so you don't need to come back to this one all that often. In terms of its location, it's at the top right of waterways, pretty out of the way. It does give you quick access to the city large room if you have the right movement, and it can get you down to basin again if you have the right movement. Aesthetically, I love this bench. It's a fun bench, but overall usefulness is kind of meh. So I'm gonna put it in C. Now I'm sure you've all been eyeing this bench, wondering what the fuck, what is this bench? There's a bench in Flukemarm? This is the deployable bench. Bench Rando gives you the ability to place down one deployable bench anywhere in the world. So it can be placed anywhere. You can warp back to it anytime. This is a randoer's godsend, because as far as I know, if you have a modded rando and it is filled with connections, you're gonna get errors, you're gonna get glitches. This bench is the debug for bench rando. It is definitely a must, so it is an S tier bench. I mean, it can be placed anywhere. My only gripe with it is that it's pretty much cheating. But hey, it's a modded game. We're already cheating. Next bench is Destroyed Tram Bench. So that check that you see is Tram Pass. So this bench gets you one check, Tram Pass. I would say this bench is okay. Honestly, I get really excited to get this bench just for that one check. And I like how they put a bench here. It's aesthetically, I love it. But again, it gets you one check, and if you don't have claw or wings, you can't get out of this room. So I would say C tier. It's a C tier bench. This is the Dirtmouth bench. So without a doubt, this is an S rank bench. In fact, it is the S rank bench. This one is reliable. It is gives you access to so many things. You can warp back here when you need to go to the shops. It is the best bench in the game. And it's the first bench you see in the game. It is your tutorial bench. It is your anchor bench. It is the best bench regardless of anything. I don't care about Butt's bench. This is the best bench. However, when Bretta is sitting on it, it's garbage. Specifically, if you have Bench Rando on and you do not get Dirtmouth bench, Bretta brings her own bench and does not let you sit on it. Every other character in the game that sits on a bench does not bring their own bench. They just sit in midair. Bretta brings her own bench and you are not allowed to sit on it. She just plops it down and you just have to stare at her. Fuck Bretta. Garbage bench. The worst bench. You can't even sit on it. Crystal, Guardian, Quirrell, Tiso, they all just sit in the air if there's not a bench there. Bretta brings her own bench if there's not a bench there. Quirrell has an animation if you sit on the bench with him, just like Bretta does. In fact, Quirrell's bench has unique because it's just... Quirrell and Bretta both have a bench that you sit on with them and they have an animation for it, and it puts you on a different side of the bench. Yeah, for some reason, Bretta gets a bench and Quirrell doesn't. I don't understand it. I don't know why it happens, but Bretta is annoying when she does this. Garbage bench. Rant over. The next bench is the Distant Reservoir bench. So this is in the Distant Village room. It's at the bottom. It is also a garbage bench. It's not the worst bench, but it's a garbage bench. You get this bench, you don't have claw, that's it. You're stuck down here. Even if you do have claw, why on earth are you down here anyways? It's a bad bench. It's a bad bench. The next bench is the Distant Village Stag bench. So in base game, this bench does not exist. It is broken. You can't use it. Bench Rando fixes that. Gives you this bench back, which automatically, I can scroll, makes it an A tier bench. It's a stag bench. It's at the top of a room. It gives you access to Distant Village. It fixes a bench that was broken. Honestly, it's an amazing bench. I would say it's A, maybe even S tier, but I'll put it in A for now. The next bench is the Durandus Trial bench. This is the bench in Green Path next to the Durandus Trial, which is the access to Shio. Honestly, I don't use this bench. It's in a bad location in Green Path. Rarely do I need to use it or get it when I need to get to Shio. It's a funny location. It's just kind of on its own little platform, but overall it's a bad bench. I don't use it. All right, the next bench is the East Lake Shore bench. This bench is a decent bench. It's Blue Lake, so it gives you decent access to Resting Grounds, Left City or Right Side City, and Salubra if you have the right materials, you know, being Claw, C-Dash if you want to be fast about it, Elevator Pass. It's a decent bench if late game. It's not great early on. It gets you like two checks, especially if you don't have Swim. So I'm going to go ahead and put this one in B. Also, it makes it really quick and easy to say hi to Quirrell before he dies. Next is Edge Summit. This is in the upper large Edge room to the right of Collector, below Colosseum. As this is the theme, any bench that's at the top of a room or at the top of an area is automatically a better bench, because if you don't have upward movement, you can fall. edge as a general is a bad area. I don't want benches in this area ever because I don't want to think about going to this area, but it's a decent bench. And climbing the room is awful without claw or wings or dash. Actually, I don't even know if it's possible without at least two of those, or one of them at least. So it's a good bench. I'll put it in B. Next is the failed tramway bench. This is a base game bench. This is the one next to where Cloth is at the top of Deep Nest. It's a good bench. Gets you access to a few different areas. From this bench, you can go to the right of Deep Nest. You can go down towards the Tanosk area. You can go left towards Failed Tramway, which also leads you down towards Galleon. It's a good bench to have, especially because it's at the top of the room. I'm gonna put it in A. The next bench is the Far Basin bench. So if you have Claw, this bench is really good because it gets you past the wings and C or C dash check to get over to Broken Vessel. If you don't have Claw, this bench is practically useless. It gets you like one check. You don't use it a whole lot late game. It'll be helpful if you need to get back here for a Mr. Mushroom check, or if you need to do Lost Kin because you couldn't do it after Broken Vessel, or you need to go back up for that grub check. It's not a bad bench. It just doesn't stand out. So C tier. Next is the Far Gardens bench. This is at the top of Queen's Gardens. And now initially you would think that, oh, it's the top of an area. It's a good bench. It's not. Well, it is at the top of the area. There is a room below it filled with thorns and spikes. If you don't have dash or claw or wings, well, actually you need dash for sure. You can get through that room. You cannot get down to lower gardens. It's not helpful. It does not get you into green path unless you've somehow been lucky enough to cut the rope, the vine on the other side of that room, which I don't think most people do. It's rare to get that right. It's a good bench if you need to get to Trader Lord quickly, but there are typically other benches that you can get to, and you're not doing Trader Lord without dash, and if you have dash, you can get through that room before it. So I would say, honestly, D. It's a D tier bench. Next one is the Flooded Stag bench. I thought this was a clever bench. This is in King Station, in the room beneath the stag, the one that leads to Edge. It's a fun bench. I kind of like it. I forget it exists. The only problem with this bench is that if you don't have upward mobility, it doesn't help you get to the stag. Also, if you don't have swim, you're trapped at this bench. So I would say on aesthetic alone, it's like B, but its usefulness brings it down to a C. Next up is Fort Flukefay. This is the one in the Flukes area, so automatically it is an F tier. F for Flukes, because Flukes are failures and fuck-ups, and just, I don't want to deal with them. It's a bad bench. I mean, the only redeeming quality about this bench is that it is a beacon of safety in a terrible room. But honestly, it's at the start of the room. It does not protect you later on. Quick access to Flukes, Fluke Marm if you want. It gets you past the dive floor if you don't have dive, but honestly, I think the funniest thing about this bench is its name, and that's it. Now, speaking of F benches, fort benches with rooms that have enemies, here's another one for you. Frog Bench, or the Fort Loodle Bench, as they're actually called. This bench is the opposite of Fort Flukefay. This bench is amazing. I love having it. It is very centralized in gardens. It's near the top, so you get access down, gets you access to the stag station, gets you access to the lever to the right. It's below Trader Lord. It's also pretty decent at keeping you safe from frogs. So I actually think this is a really good one. I think A tier. A tier bench. It's a fun one to have. The next bench is the Fungal Core bench. I have mixed feelings about this one. It doesn't actually get you into Fungal Core unless you have wings and claw. So it doesn't help you get past any requirement checks. However, it is pretty good at getting you to Mantis Village. Entering magic field from above is arguably better than entering it from the right. So this will get you a few checks. And, you know, once you do have wings and claw, this one's a quick comeback too. Easy to get to fungal core from this one. Obviously, it's meant to. So I'll put this one in B. Next bench is the fungal road bench. This bench is possibly the superior bench to Crossroads Hot Springs bench. This bench is in the room right above the Longfall fungal room, where next to Leg Eater. From this bench, you get easy access to fungal waste, easy access to Crossroads. I just don't get this bench all that often. It's just kind of meh, but I think usefulness puts it up in A. It's a decent bench, reliable. It's a good placement. However, there is a similar bench very close to this bench that is far superior, and that is the Fungal Tower bench. This is the bench in the room next to Leg Eater. I don't know why, but it is my favorite bench. Like, in the game, it's my favorite bench. I love getting this bench. I don't know why. So it's an S tier bench. I will not be taking criticism. It's a great bench. There is no bias here. The next bench is Galleon's Grave bench. So putting this together, I had to think long and hard about this bench because it feels more useful than it is, honestly. It gets you access to the lifeblood check and to Galleon. Helpful if you need the Mr. Mushroom in the room. But other than that, it's okay. It's not like fantastic. It gets you access to Dark Deepness if you don't have Lantern. If you do have Lantern, then great. I think all in all, this is an average bench. It's pretty centralized, so C tier. The next bench is Gardens Atrium bench. This is also a very good bench. Very centralized in Queen's Gardens. This is in the room, two rooms to the right of the Stag Station, up the top. It gives you the same access as Fort Lutel bench. So if you can get to one of them, you can get to the other. It's just a good central location. If you have the Queen's Gardens block open, you can get down to Petra Arena. You can get over to Fog Canyon if you have Isma's. It's just a good centralized bench. I like this one a lot, so B tier. Our next bench. This is the Gardens Corner for bench. So in Queen's Gardens, corner verse to the right of the Petra Arena, this is the bench in that room. This is a base game bench. It's an okay bench. Without claw, it doesn't give you access to a whole lot. It's a safety bench, if anything, especially for speedruns. But in a rando, I don't find myself using this bench all that often. Aesthetically, it's very pleasing. It's a very peaceful area. But I would say, all in all, it's an average bench. Gets you a couple checks if you have the right materials. So I'll put it in C. Next up, this bench is the Garden Stag bench. A great bench. Stag bench, centralized. I think Team Cherry knew what they were doing when they put stag benches into the game. It's a good bench. It's reliable. Not as great as Atrium or Fort Lutel in terms of access. You need vertical movement for this one to get up to the top. I would prefer having Fort Lutel or more likely Atrium to get to access this area. But all in all, this is a stag bench, so I'd put this in B. Next up is the Gardens Toll bench. This is a garbage bench. Maybe not like F tier garbage, but it's not a great bench. It's too far to the left. It doesn't get you access to anything unless you have both dash and claw. You can fall down if you want into, like, you can go down from here into deepness, but again, you need claw or wings. It's a backup bench at best. If you don't have any benches nearby, which more likely you are going to, you can rely on this bench to just be near-ish to the area, but there are better benches, so I'm putting this one in D. Godhome Atrium bench. This is the bench in Godhome, obviously, in the central area. You rarely get this in a rando. It just doesn't happen a lot much. And unless your goal is to do Pantheons in a rando, which you know, some people do, but for the most part, isn't the goal. It doesn't have a whole lot of use. Aesthetically, it's unique. I mean, it's a God Home bench. So it's a pretty cool bench. And it does give you access to Junk Pit if you do not have access to it yet, which is actually pretty good. However, if you don't have access to Junk Pit, you cannot get out of Junk Pit. So I would say that's as far as usefulness goes. I would say C. It's average. God Home Roof. In a rando, you never get this bench. It never happens. Base game though, this is a fun bench to get. This is the hardest bench to get in the game, obviously, because you need to go through four pantheons to get access to it. It's just a fun little place on the side of P5. You know, this is probably where I spend most of my time in my pantheon playthroughs. So it's a fun bench. I enjoy it. In a rando, it's useless. So D. The next is Green Path Entrance. Rarely do I use this bench. It's on the far right of Green Path, nearest entrance, right after the Balder. If that Balder is not dead, which honestly, I don't kill that Balder all that much in randos. I tend to start off in places to the left of it. But if that Balder is not dead, you can't get to Crossroads from this bench. So if you want to use it to get to Crossroads, you have to make sure to go to Crossroads first. So, and that kind of brings down its rating. As for Green Path itself, it's in the far right. There are, I think, any other bench in Green Path besides Shio's bench. Any other bench in Green Path is superior to it because you'll get to checks faster. So I'll put this one also in D. I just don't like it. Next up is the Green Path Stag Bench. Good location. Obviously it's a stag bench, so great there. Easy access to Hornet, which is, you know, the dash pickup. Relics are nearby, good checks, Finch Liking, Grubs. So this gets you a lot of checks. It's probably one of the best Green Path benches. I prefer this one over Toll, even though Toll is lower down, more centralized. It's a good bench. I'll put it in B. You rarely come back to this bench though, because Green Path is such an early game area. Next is the Green Path Toll Bench. Very centralized. This is a great Green Path bench. If I were to pick one bench out of Green Path to get, I would probably pick Stag, but this would be my second pick. It's just central. It's in a good spot. You know, it gets you access to a lot of checks. Again, it's Green Path, so most checks are readily available at the start of the game. You don't need a whole lot to get to this stuff. So I'll put this one in B as well. Gray Mourner Bench is an F tier bench. I don't want to look at this bench. I don't want to touch this bench. This bench is solely for the flower quest, and that's it. And in Orlando, it's not even useful for that. I don't want this bench at all. Its only redeeming quality is that it gets you to Crypts access, and that's it. I would say, yeah, it's definitely an F tier bench. On the other hand, Grubfather Bench. S tier bench. Without a doubt, great bench. Quick access to Grubfather, especially in a room rando. In a room rando, you want to come back to Grubs as much as possible, but you're not going to know where they are. This bench in a room rando is phenomenal. It's a great bench. My only problem with this bench is that I forget to check it's there. I walk into Grubfather's room, I read the tablet, and I walk out. I never walk to the other side of this room to check for this bench. So S tier bench, just I need to remember to check for it. But it is important to have access to Grubfather, especially if you randomize grubs. Money and checks. Next bench is Golka Goalie Bench. This is the bench to the left of Massive Moss Charger. Early game, it's a decent bench to get because it gets you over to that area without dash or wings or C dash to get into the mossy room. Late game, it's not that useful. It's kind of out of the way. Hopefully by then you have done all the checks in the area. There are just better benches nearby. That's the problem with most of the green path benches is late game, they're kind of garbage. Just in general, green path late game is garbage. This is an average bench, so I'll put it in C. Hall of Gods bench. This is like in between Atrium, Got Home Atrium bench, and Got Home Roof bench. You can get this bench in a rando. It gives you junk pick access if you have claw, and only if you have claw. Other than that, it's pretty much useless. So I'm actually going to put it in D. If I were to pick any God Home bench, and rarely do I want a God Home bench, it would be Atrium. Next up is Hermit's Approach bench. This bench is rare. I rarely get this bench in a rando. It's in the room in between Junk Pit and Nailsmith's area. And to the right of this bench is where you find the Fluke Hermit. It's pretty useless. If you don't have Swim, this bench is actually useless. It doesn't get you anywhere. You need Swim to get out of this area. And from there, you get access to Junk Pit, which is all you get. Or you can go up to Nailsmith, which you should have gotten pretty soon anyways. Early game, terrible bench. I just think it's fun because of Hermit, but for the most part, meh, D tier. Next bench is Hidden Station Stag Bench. Same thing as before, it's a stag bench. Gets you access to lower basin if you don't have claw, and abyss if you have King's Brand. It's a good bench. Like most stag benches, I would say it's A tier. Next bench is the Hive Bench, aka the Sticky Bench. It's a bad bench in Orlando. It's at the bottom of an area that is meant to have claw and wings, so it's also just pretty far off to the left. It's not my favorite bench. I would say it's D tier, the D tier bench. It's a bad bench. I don't like this bench. I do not enjoy getting it. I do not like warping to this bench because it takes forever to get to Hive Knight. I don't know. It's just not a great bench. But the next bench is Hive Exterior. So this bench does not actually get you to Hive. It gets you right outside of Hive, in the room to the left of Hive where Mr. Mushroom is, above the lower tram. This is an average bench, pretty good, doesn't give you access to much, but late game, it can be pretty reliable. Obviously helpful with Mr. Mushroom. So I will go ahead and put this one at C tier. Now, for a real bench, Hive Hideaway Bench. Centralized behind a breakable wall that you can get through, immediately gives you access to one check that is actually decently annoying to get to because you have to have Big B break a wall to get to it. I really love this bench. It's a good location for Hive, reliable. I would say this is an A tier bench. Next up is the Hornet's Outpost bench. This is just camp bench, but closer to Hornet. So aesthetically, I think it's pleasing. It's fun to have. It makes getting back to that Hornet fight faster if you're bad at it. So I'll put it with C, with camp bench, because they're basically the same bench. They are actually the same bench. Look at that. Arguably, camp bench is better because it has a check next to it that you need claw to get to, so, or wings. The next bench is the Hunter's Hideout Bench. This is the bench where Hunter is. In a rando, you rarely return to Hunter. You rarely have need to return to Hunter. In terms of location, it's a bit far to the right of Green Path. It's pretty useful, especially if you need to go down out of Green Path. It can be pretty fast. I would prefer other benches though. But overall, it's an average bench. I'll put C in C. Next up is Inner Sanctum Bench. Inner Sanctum Bench is in the same room as Soul Master. So it's at the top of Sanctum. So this bench gives you access to Sanctum, even if you don't have vertical movement, gets you quick access to a boss, but most importantly, it gets you past Sanctum's Hell Room with the three Spell Twisters. And it's a good location. It's a good bench to have if you need to return back to Sanctum to do the dive room to the left, or to fight Soul Tyrant. So this is a, I'd say this is a B, maybe an A tier. Let's go with B. It's a B tier bench. Following along with pretty decent benches, Yzma's Grove bench. This is an okay bench. Gets you access to Yzma's Grove if you don't have the skill or Yzma's to get through the acid. I don't return to this bench very often. It's a low average bench. Its redeeming quality is that it gets you past acid, and that's about it. It doesn't really help you get into waterways unless you have C-dash. All in all, it's an average bench. Now, Isolated Cell. This is the bench at the top of Hive that you can only get to by going through the like edge area above Hive, which, you know, requires both dive and an acid skip. Getting this bench early on gets you one check, and that's it. You need vertical movement, C-dash, wings. You need something to get you past acid, and even then, there's a breakable floor that you cannot get through. But there's another check. So this is actually a pretty bad bench. D. The next bench is Joni's Repose bench. This is in Cliffs, where you pick up Joni's Blessing, just slightly to the left of Joni. If you do not have vertical movement, you cannot get out of this room. The bench itself is pretty lackluster. It's in a pretty location, but Joni is not like a fantastic check. Also, the room to the left is a dark room. So I wouldn't say it's a great bench, but helpful if you need to get past the dark room. So I'll put it in D as well. Next up, King's Door bench. This is an easy access to Abyss bench if you have King's Brand. One of the things I have issues with this bench is that if you have Lifeblood charms to equip so that you can get access to Lifeblood Core, I would say it's silly because you actually can't equip it here. You have to leave the room and come back for it to work. You need Claw to leave this room, go up, but any access to Abyss is pretty nice. I would say it's a decent bench. I actually really enjoy getting it. And it also gets you a check to the right of it. So I'm gonna put this one in B, the B tier bench. I like having this one. This is the King's Pass bench. So this bench is in the top left of King's Pass, which is interesting. I never remember this bench. I always forget it exists. You need a vertical movement to get out of this room. And even then, you need more vertical movement to get into Cliffs. Falling down is pretty easy with or without Claw. You can just pogo your way through the spikes to get you access to King's Pass. It's a okay backup if you don't have Dirtmouth bench, but I'd say B tier. King's Pass is an important area, has a lot of checks, so this gives you access to that, which you rarely get in a rando. Next up is King's Station bench. I'm gonna put this one in A. It's a stag bench. It's a reliable stag bench. It's a good stag bench. King Station is probably one of my most used benches, if I have it. You have access to left side, or right side city, and left side city. Well, if you have swim, you get access to edge. If you have vertical movement, access above it, up to that arena. It's just a good bench. Ooh, a white palace bench. This is the King's Mold Duelist bench. So this is in the early areas of White Palace, down at the bottom. I don't like this bench at all. It doesn't help you get anywhere in White Palace. It's too early on. You need the entrance lever open if you have lever randomized. It doesn't actually help you get to the lever if you don't have wings and claw. It's just not a great bench. I don't like it that much. It doesn't help. It's not one I prefer in White Palace. Next bench is the Lake of Un bench. In terms of usefulness, this bench is pretty bad. It's too far to the left to be helpful in green path. You need dash to get out of it. If anything, it's helpful to go back to Un if you need to do that, but that's one check. So I would put this in D, but it does have Quirrell, so we'll put it in C. Leg Eater bench, this is a A tier bench, without a doubt. This is a bench that gets you access to a shop. And you know, if you're bad at the game and you break your charms, this is a quick way to come back and get them fixed. Plus, it gets you access to fungal wastes. It's a really good bench. It might actually be S tier, but I'm gonna leave it here in A tier for now. Next bench is, I believe this is the lower. This is the lower tram bench. Lower tram bench, S tier bench. If you get this bench, you don't need tram pass to get access to Deep Nest, Abyss or Basin, Hive. It's a very centralized location, gets you access to a lot of different areas. I come back to this bench a lot. And I really do like that it replaces tram pass, pretty much. It's a very, very useful bench. Definitely S tier. The next bench is Lurker's Overlook bench. Just as with the Kalo bench, this is an F tier bench. It is not helpful in any way. I don't care to fight Lurker. She's a bad, not boss, I guess. And of course, if you want to get out of this area, you still need Claw to get out of Colosseum. It's a bad bench. I don't like it. This is Mantis Hub bench. So this is in the hub room above Mantis Lords. This is either an A or S tier bench. This bench is basically Mantis Lord's access, and it's a pretty decent bench for a lot of different checks. I really enjoy getting this bench. I'm actually going to put it in S tier. It's an S tier bench. What's to follow is Mantis Village bench. This is the one in the room to the left of Mantis Lords, the one that you have to fight Mantis Lords to get access to. Now, you would think that having a bench in this room would let you get out of this room, but that is not the case. Team Cherry put up an invisible wall in that room, so you can't get out if you haven't fought Mantis Lords. This does give you early access to a couple of different checks, and once you have fought Mantis Lords, it's a pretty centralized location, not too bad. I enjoy getting it, but definitely not as much as Mantis Hub, so I'll put it in A. Mato bench is an A tier bench, definitely for sure. Access to Mato, who we all love. Access to Mr. Mushroom if he's there. Cliffs, it's a top of cliffs. Obviously, I would prefer Cliff Overhang just because it's closer to the falling room. But this is a pretty decent bench too. Mato's bench is an excellent bench. Millibelle bench is an F tier bench. Millibelle's a bad person and I don't want to be anywhere near her. The only redeeming quality of this bench is that it's near Queen Station. So it's a decent backup if you don't have Queen Station bench. But that's about it. It's an F tier. It's a bad bench. I don't want to deal with Millibelle. All right, next up is Mimic's Secret Bench. So in Peak, to the left of Peak, there's the room with the Mimic and Grub. This bench is behind the breakable wall. This bench has its ups and downs. Without vertical movement, you're trapped in this room. And without C dash and claw, you can't get to Peak. With dash and wings or C dash, you can get over to Dirtmouth. I would say this is a better Dirtmouth backup bench compared to the King's Pass bench. But other than that, it's not like a fantastic bench. I'll put it in C. The Mining Golem bench. This bench doesn't pop up a lot in my randos. It's an okay bench. It doesn't stand out. It's all the way to the right of Peak. You can't get to check many checks from here. There are just better Peak checks. I'm gonna go ahead and put this one in D. It doesn't stand out. It's not super helpful. Okay, so this next one is the Myla bench. Well, in terms of usefulness, it's on the far right of Crossroads. Basically, it gets you some access. I mean, again, Crossroads is an area where all checks are pretty much accessible from the start. So it doesn't help you get any checks per se. Before C-Dash, it's a great bench. After it, it's kind of a sad one. I'm gonna go ahead and put it in B for my conflicted emotions. Nailsmith bench, A. Just like Leg Eater bench, this is a great bench to have if you are randomizing nail upgrades. So that means you're close to a shop. Other than that, it doesn't give you a lot of access. Actually, you know what? I'm putting this in B because of that. I don't, not everyone I know upgrades in randos. So this one's actually kind of less useful than Leg Eater's Bench. And like I said before, Left Side City is default city access. You want other areas. So I'm gonna go ahead and put this one in B. It's a useful bench sometimes. Next up is the Nightmare Lantern Bench. This is another cliff bench. This one's lower than Joni's Repose Bench, higher than Blasted Plains Bench. This bench isn't very useful. If you can do the top of cliffs, you can do more than what you can do with this bench. It's just, if you need to summon troop, this is the quickest way to get to the lantern. It's fairly centralized in cliffs, I guess. I wouldn't put a whole lot of stock into it, so I'll put it in D. Nosk's Lair Bench. Y'all want early access to Nosk? Here you go. This is in the same room as Nosk's, just before the trap doors start closing. It's not an okay bench. It's a bad bench. I don't like this bench. Getting this bench in a rando is basically just saying, go fight Nosk now. And getting out of this room is a hassle. I'm gonna go with D. It's honestly no better than any other deepness bench, that's for sure. Ornate Door Bench. So this is the one right next to the Ornate Door, which is where you use Elegant Key to get access to the Shade Soul area. It's in the same room as the Toll Bench, so it's a kind of a backup to the Toll Bench. However, it's slightly better because it's on the right side of the breakable wall and gives you access to Sanctum without having to do the spell twister fight. So I think it's a good bench. I'm gonna put it in B. I like getting this bench in randos just because of its location. And it is at the top of Left Side City. So it's a good bench. Oro Bench, there with Mato's bench. Love Oro. Right Side Edge isn't super great, but this one is helpful for all the checks next to the dive floor to the right. Oro is obviously not as great as Mato because of the 800 Geo cost to get whatever item he has, but this is a good bench. I like this bench. There are better edge benches, but we love a good NPC. Outer Sanctum Bench. So this bench is on the right side of Sanctum at the bottom of the room. If you go to the left transition, you'll find the entrance to Sanctum behind the lever door. It's a decent bench, not as great as the Inner Sanctum Bench in terms of access to Sanctum. However, to access to city, it's not that bad. I would put this one, like I enjoy Sanctum benches. So I'll put this one in C then. All right, Overgrown Atrium Bench. I get this bench a lot. It's in a pretty decent location. Early game, it's not super, super helpful. You can go from here to the left side Fog Canyon. If you don't have Claw, you cannot get to Overgrown Mound. There's a lever to the right and a shade wall to the left. It's just an okay bench. However, late game, it's actually very useful. Gets you access to Mound, gets you access to Gardens, gets you access to Mr. Mushroom. I come back here a lot late game, so I'm actually going to put this one in B. Now, speaking of Overgrown Mound, the Overgrown Mound bench is basically the Atrium bench, but better. So I'm actually gonna put Atrium bench in C and this one in B. Sure, it gives you like one extra transition, but you know, it gives you access to the two checks that are in this room, you know, despite the arena. And then you can just walk out and you'll be in the exact same place as the Atrium bench. So I think it's better. So I'll put it in B. The Padded Door Bench. So this is the entrance Tower of Love and the collector fight. In terms of Tower of Love alone, this is a decent bench, especially if you die to collector a lot. Quick and easy access to collector. And what's more important is it's at the top of this room. So if you don't have Claw, you can still get to every transition. To the right, we have the upper edge room, although you'll be near the bottom of it, but that's access to areas. Going down gets you access to city. I think overall, this is actually a very, very good bench. It's centrally located, top of the room, I would actually probably put this one in A. White Palace Atrium Bench. So this bench is in, is base game bench in White Palace. It's a good centralized bench, you know, as Team Cherry intended. I'll put it in B. The only problem with White Palace benches is that you need a lot of materials and checks and skills to get through this room, these areas. This one doesn't help you get to anything. It's just once you have those items, then you can get to everything. But it's a good bench to have. The next bench is the Palace Balcony Bench. This is also a default bench. Better than the Atrium Bench because it puts you past the lever checks. So you don't need to get to both the levers, the White Palace orbs. This gets you more locations. I would say this is a better bench of the two White Palace benches we just talked about. The next one is Palace East. This is right side palace. From here, you can either drop down through a bunch of buzzsaws and make your way to the left, only to find a wall that you need claw to get over. Or you can go to the left, do some random skips that you definitely need at least dash and claw for. Dash and claw or dash and wings for. And then you can get access to like two checks. And then you can actually get out of this room. It's a decent bench. I don't see it a whole lot, but it's useful. I'll put it in C. Next one is Palace Grounds. So this is in the basin room, which White Palace is held in, far to the left of the King's Mold. This is basically no different than the Hidden Station bench. It gets you the access to the same areas. It's pretty much the same. So I will put this one tier below Hidden Station just because it's not that creative comparatively. It's a good backup though. So B tier. Next up is Palace West. This is to the left side of Palace Atrium, in the top left-ish of the area. So right below you have the buzzsaws that cross your paths. To the right of this, you have the tunnel with buzzsaws. There aren't really any checks in this area. If you go down, there is one check. And then of course to the right is the lever for the palace orb. Again, not like super noteworthy. I'll put it with the other palace bench. Next up is the palace workshop bench. So this gives you access to topmost palace. There's a check in this room, and then if you leave this room, if you have C-dash, you can get up to the King's Fragment check. It doesn't give you like a whole lot of access without abilities, but definitely preferable to the other two, just because it gets you access behind levers and doors. So I'll put this one in B. Next up is the Pantheon Midbench. So this is the bench that you sit on if you're doing Pantheons. This is by far the most useful Pantheon bench. It gives you a heal, and that's really about it. Actually, I take it back. It's not that useful. There's, you know, a hot spring in the same room. So, you know, it gives you access to change your charms if you're doing Pantheons. I don't typically do that. I'll put it in B tier for now. Path of Pain Midpoint Bench. One of the reasons why I love this bench so much is because it lets me do some Path of Pain rooms backwards, but also its usability in Path of Pain is great. If you randomize soul totems, you lose those in Path of Pain. So this is an area to rest, get soul back, change your charms. Plus, if you ever find that Path of Pain is too hard, you can just warp back to here when you're ready. It's a good, reliable bench. I love it. I don't get it all that often. I don't get to do Path of Pain all that often in randos. I definitely think it's A tier. The next bench is the Peaks Dark Room Bench. This is a base game bench down at the bottom of Peak. And as I said before, Peak is a very climb, vertical heavy movement area. So a bench at the bottom isn't all that helpful. I would say C tier. Its usefulness as a peak bench is meh, but it does. I do find myself coming back to this bench a lot when I have movement, especially claw. So I'll put this in C. Next up is the peak entrance bench. So this is in the dive room on the far left of peak. This is an interesting bench because you need vertical to get into this room from below and you need dive to get into this room from above. If you get this bench, it's no different than the darkroom bench in terms of access. I would say it's also a pretty C tier. It's honestly, it's worse than darkroom because it's really far to the left and you're most likely to have some crossroad bench that'll be better for you. I'd say it's a C tier bench. Next bench is the Peak Ravine bench. So in the room to the left of Crystal Mound and to the right of Peak is the big ravine that falls down into Resting Grounds in the Zero fight. In that room, there is a ledge on the wall that's just there. Nothing sits there. It's just there. And someone geniusly decided to put a bench there. It makes total sense in my brain. Usefulness, however, meh. You get this bench and you get access to Resting Grounds and Resting Grounds only. In no way is it possible to go from this bench to Peak. I would say put it in C. It's creativity. Its aesthetic is perfect. So I'm putting it in B. Next up is Pilgrim's Start. So this is the start of Pilgrim's Way. So this is in the crossroads room to the left of the big Gruz room where the Balder is. This bench is a good crossroads bench. I think this bench has better access to crossroads than the Hot Springs bench. It's worse than the Grubfather bench, obviously. I would prefer this bench over the Crossroads Center bench in terms of access to Dirtmouth and Black Egg. And it's a bit closer to Green Path if you have a Balder Killer. I don't use this bench all that much unless I don't have the other benches. So I'll put it in B. I actually really like this bench. I personally should use it more often if it's there. All right, however, Pilgrim's End bench is A tier. Very good location, centralized, access to a lot of areas. I come back to this one a lot. Plus sometimes Hornet's there, so that's cool. In terms of access, it's no different than Cloth's Approach bench. You can just pogo your way up there. It's a fun bench. I enjoy this one. It's like a good midway point between Leg Eater, Elder Who, and Mantis Village. Whereas the other ones are kind of more leaning towards one of the others. So I think its centrality is really what bumps it up. Next up is Pleasure House Bench. Another Hot Springs bench, also considered Kill Marissa bench. Its usefulness is meh. There are better benches in City. Getting this bench early on though, however, is nice because you can go to the right, break the wall, and drop down into Station. But later game, it's kind of meh. I'll put it in B. It's early game usefulness bumps it up a bit more than other benches. Next up is Prophet's Gate bench. So this is quite the bench. Obviously we have an NPC in Moss Prophet, assuming Moss Prophet is not dead. You can go from this bench and drop down into Lit Deep Nest. You can go to the right and get some checks depending on your movement abilities. If you can break down the wall, it gets you quick access to parts of Queen's Garden. So I think all in all, it's actually an A tier bench, mostly because of Moss Prophet and its ability and your access to Deep Nest through it. Plus there are a lot of checks you can get from this one. Also, there aren't a lot of benches nearby Prophet's Gate. So this is a good bench to have if you're in the area exploring. You just need to like return here every now and then. The next bench is the Pure Altar bench. So this bench is in the room where you get Quick Slash below Oro. And honestly, the aesthetic of this bench is probably one of my favorite things. I love finding this bench in this room. I love getting this bench and getting early access to this area. In terms of usefulness later on though, it's kind of meh. It's a decent backup to Oro's bench. However, you still need Claw or Wings to get up over to Oro from here or to get out of here. But I think the aesthetic of it, I just love the lore in this area. So I'll put it in B. Next up is a stag bench. Which stag bench? Queen Station stag bench. very good bench. It's a very good bench. I'm actually going to put, it's definitely an A tier bench, as most stag benches are. It's a stag bench. Gets you access to Fog Canyon. You just need one movement ability and you can get over to Fungal Waste. It's a good centralized bench. And when I say centralized bench here, I mean between different areas. It's a good bench. Next up is Quirrell's Peak Bench. This is an S rank bench. One, it has Quirrell. Two, it is at the top of Peak, but not so high as to be Crown Ascent. When doing a rando, that center section of Peak is probably one of the most annoying areas to do because you need claw for it. This is the top of that room. From here, you can get pretty much every check in Peak below it, except for like Enraged Guardian. If I had to choose between this one and Crown Ascent, I would pick this one. Crown Ascent is good, but it's not as helpful or as useful as this one, and it doesn't have Quirrell. So this is the superior bench. Next up is the Remote Acid Sluice Bench. So this bench is in a weird location. It's in Right Side Waterways near Isma's Grove, above Isma's Grove. It is behind a breakable wall. So if you get this bench, you can get down into the Isma's Grove area. It's not super helpful unless you have the Isma's access stuff. It's also, there is access if you have C-dash or Isma's tier. Access to Edge. Like, I'll be honest, I feel like this bench could actually be very useful. It just never is. So it's a D tier bench. So next up is Resting Ground Stag Station. So this room has a bench, a lever, and a stag station. It has like, I don't know why, but it has like more checks in this room than other rooms for some reason. However, this bench gives access to Resting Grounds. So you have access to Seer, Dream Shield, Dive into Crypts, and if you have Ghost Essence Rando on, so many checks in Spirit's Glade. Honestly, this is a really good bench to have, you know, going, especially with Seer, having to go back to Seer as often as we do in randos. A, I'm actually tempted to put it in S, depending on how many checks it gives you access to, depending on what your settings are. It's a good bench to have. Next up is Saluber Bench. S tier bench, without a doubt, no questions, S tier bench. Same reasons as Dirtmouth, you get access to someone who has a lot of checks, usually. Not only that, but it gets you access to Sly. So if you have not found Sly and you get this bench, you can go find Sly. From here, if you have Wings and Claw, or C-dash, you can get to the Blue Lake and go from there. It's also not a bad bench for infected crossroads because it's basically in the middle of that area you have to walk around when it gets infected. So like this is actually a decent bench to if you have to fight like Fail Champion and you don't have the Stag Station bench, this is a good bench to have as replacement. So I think I really love Saluber's bench. I enjoy getting it. Next up is the Sanctuary Vault Bench. Trash bench. Very trash bench. You get access to one check if you don't have Lantern. If you do have Lantern, you can go fight No Eyes. And from there, it's a long trek to the left to get back to Green Path. I don't use this bench unless I have literally no other options. And as a seasoned player, I also can get through Sanctuary, Dark Sanctuary pretty easily. So the bench isn't necessary. Like, there's a good chance I'll find this bench before I ever find the check for it. I think it's an F tier bench. Next up is the Sawblade Choir Bench. I love the name of this bench. Sawblade Choir Bench is probably one of my favorite named benches because it is a bench surrounded by sawblades. In terms of usefulness, it's kind of meh. It doesn't help you get a whole lot of access unless you have the movement in White Palace, as most White Palace benches are. I'm gonna put it in C tier. Actually, we're gonna put it in B tier just because of the name alone. It's just a fun bench. I like the name, because you do. You sit down, you get this check, you warp to it, and it's just a bunch of saw blades singing at you. Shio Bench. A. I actually was tempted to put Shio Bench in S because Shio is clearly the best, but the bench itself is kind of useless. It's so far out of the way. that it just doesn't help with anything. I mean, quick access to Shio if you get this first, but honestly, other than Shio, there's not much in this area that's worth the bench. The other two Nail Master benches at least give you other areas to look through. This one just is at a dead end. So, A tier. Spirit's Glade bench, A tier bench. For the same reasons that the Stag bench is here, all the same access. In fact, this one's actually better because you can walk to the left out the door even if you haven't unlocked, open the door yet. So and if you have to do Revic for any reason, hey, there's a bench in the room that you can spawn at if you somehow manage to die. So, I mean, I obviously, in a rando, I don't need both this one and the Stag Station. Both of them are just as good as each other. So I think it's definitely A tier. All right, next up is the Stag Nest bench. This is an added bench to the mod because Stagness does not have a bench. But this is actually, I think this is an A tier bench. Again, it's not actually a stag bench because if you get this bench, there isn't actually a bell to ring to call the stag. However, it does give you access to all of Cliffs. If you had to choose one bench in Cliffs, it would be this one. The Cliffs overhang bench is definitely better than it. But if you were to pick one, pick this one, because you can get all the checks in the area with this one bench, which I think brings it up to A tier, despite it not actually being a stag bench. Next up is Stone Sanctuary bench. I would say this is a B tier. It's very centralized in Green Path. It gives you quick access to a bunch of different areas. Not a lot of checks though, but again, as Green Path is, there aren't many checks you can't get too quickly. I mean, it's just a good B tier bench. Next bench is the Temple Exterior bench. So this is the one that's right outside Black Egg Temple. So, which is actually kind of funny because there are three Black Egg Temple benches. The one that's inside Black Egg, the one that's inside the temple, and the one that's outside the temple. This is the one outside the temple. I'm gonna go ahead and put it in B because it's pretty good, not the best out of the three. But it does give you good access to crossroads and the area surrounding. It's a pretty good bench. Temple interior, or the temple seal bench, is an A tier bench. Especially if you have room or door randomizer on, this one puts you in Black Egg. Whereas the other one outside doesn't actually get you access to Black Egg, it just gives you access to another transition. This one guarantees that you are inside. So if you have all three dreamers, you're good to go here. I would prefer this bench over the one outside of it. Next up is the Thorny Respite bench, F tier, terrible bench. This is in right side palace in a small area filled with thorns that you need wings and claw to get out of. It is useless. It is terrible. Don't even try checking for this bench. I don't care for it. It is bad. The bad, bad bench. Naughty little bench. However, Throne Approach bench is much better. Possibly A tier. It's definitely, yeah, I'd say A tier. I don't have a lot to say for this one. It's just the top of White Palace. Claw and C-dash, you can get up to the flight fragment. And with Claw and C-dash, you can get back down. So I say it's an A-tier bench. Next bench is Tower of Love bench. Earlier we talked about the padded door bench. And I said one of its superior aspects of the tower door bench was that it was at the top of the room. So if you didn't have Claw, you could still get out. This is the inverse. It's the same room, practically the same position, just below it. So it has the same benefits as the tower of, or the padded door bench, but it's just in a worse location. And because of that, you can't, unless you have claw, you can't get up. So that means no access to the Tower of Love, no access to edge or upper edge. So I would say that puts this at a C. Next up is Trader's Grave. So this is the area where Flower Quest ends. So this bench is guarded by a slightly challenging, not really, thorn area. It sits in between the Fort Lutel bench and the Stag Station bench, and to the room to the left of the Atrium bench. There are a lot of benches in this area. I would say that this is probably the worst out of the four of them. So I'm actually going to put it in D. I don't care for this bench. It doesn't help. The only way this would be helpful is if I had to do Flower Quest and I had this bench. I could just warp here. But most people, including me, would see that as cheating. So I wouldn't do it anyways. Next up is Trap Bench. F tier bench. It's garbage. I don't know why they'd put this here. I mean, the only redeeming quality of this bench is that it's a good place to sit and rest. A very good place to sit and rest. In fact, you should sit and rest. The next bench is Un's Chamber Bench. Un's Chamber is an easy way to get access to the Shape of Un check if you don't have Isma's. However, most people would have Isma's anyways, or wouldn't think to do this unless they had Isma's or C-dash and Claw. Because you can't do it without Isma's. It's just, there isn't a lot in this area. I mean, it's I would say it's worse than the Lake of Un check, so I would say D tier. It's not that great. Upper Tram Bench, C tier for sure. The Lower Tram Bench is far, 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 far more superior. It gets you so much access to so many things. This one barely gets you anything. It's between two different areas, and both areas are pretty much designed to be accessed other ways. I mean, Crossroads, you're supposed to already be in, and Resting Ground has other ways of getting into it that I would prefer over this one. I don't think I've ever in Orlando used Upper Tram to get into Resting Grounds, so I'm gonna leave it in C tier. I'll give it the benefit of the doubt, but that's where it is. Watcher's Skyway Bench. So this is the bench to the left of the Watcher's Tower, in that really long room that's like a bridge. It's on the left side of the lever door. So getting this without the lever doesn't actually give you access to the Watcher's Spire. And it is in fact worse than getting storerooms access, because you need wings or claw to get up. And if you go down, there are two lever doors and only one lever can be opened. So it's kind of meh. I'm actually going to put it in C though, because once all these doors are open and once you have the right movement, it's a pretty good centralized bench. It's a good limb bench. It's a good watcher's bench. It's a good storerooms bench. It's very centralized, but it's just more of a late game bench than an early game bench. Next up is the Watcher's Spire Bench. This is the base game bench that they put in that room below Watchers. It's a good safety bench. Nice to have, especially for people who are just starting out. It's a good bench. It's a good, again, it's a nice, reliable bench that's very safe. Good access. Only issues about this bench is that you need claw to get to it. But once you have the check and you can warp to it, it's not really much of an issue. So I think it's a B tier bench. Next up is the Green Path Waterfall Bench. Superior for sure to the Green Path Entrance Bench. Closer to Green Path, probably better. But I really don't use this one all that often. It's not like super useful. It has a good aesthetic, but in terms of usefulness and the amount of checks it gets us to, it's not much better than anything else in Green Path. So I'll leave it at C. Waterways Bench, the slanted one. The most unique bench in base game. The only one like it. S tier. Also very good location. A bit annoying if you get it really early and you can't climb up because you have to actually break those floors with dive. So I would say that's its only downfall, is that you need to go up and around and break through the floors so you can go back up later on, but that's not a huge issue. S tier bench. Waterways Entrance Bench, A tier. In Waterways, it doesn't matter exactly where a Waterways bench is. This one is definitely the best out of all of them, except for the default or base game bench. From here, you can get anywhere without claw. Well, almost anywhere without claw. You can go down. But any bench that's like getting you access to waterways before the key is nice. I just really like this bench. It's a good location for a bench to be in a rando. Like I said, one of the problems with this with the main waterways bench is that if you don't have claw or dive, it's kind of iffy. This one is less of an issue there. You can get to more places without those abilities. Weaver's Den Bench. I'm not sure where to put this one. Early access to a lit area in a dark area. Getting this early access doesn't mean a whole lot. Later on, it's a decent bench. I'm actually going to put it in C. It's not super useful long term. Comes up a couple times, but for the most part, you don't use this bench all that often. It's nice to have it when you have like doors randomized or transitions randomized, as are most benches behind doors. But I would say this one's not super helpful. West Lake Shore Bench. This one is just as useful as East Lake Shore Bench, except maybe even a little more. Because if you have claw but don't have swim, you can get to Salubra. I'll say this one's A tier. This one's A tier. Western Peak Bench. Western Peak Bench is D tier. Honestly, it's D tier. It is a bench that's in a location that you cannot leave or enter into unless you have C-dash. So it is functionally useless without C-dash. Once you have C-dash, it's okay. You're still pretty far left of Peak and pretty far right of Dirtmouth. So I'm honestly being generous, giving it a D instead of an F. The next bench we have is Zote's Skyway Bridge. This is the bench on the bridge in between Sanctum and Storerooms. It's a decent bench, actually. A good replacement for City Soul Bench and not too far away from the Storerooms bench. I'd actually give this one a B. I like getting this bench. It's a good starting location, too. And our last bench is Zote's Folly Bench. This is the bench in Deep Nest after the Corpse Creepers arena. And as you can see in the picture, it is right next to our good friend Zote. So if you get this bench and you warp to it, you are getting an earful of Zote right away. And you are suggested to save Zote. So, F tier. And that is it. I have ranked all the benches in the game, including the ones modded. Ooh. That's all of them. Honestly, I think it's pretty well balanced. I skewed a little bit more towards the positive than the negative. What do you know? But yeah, that's my ranking for benches. I really enjoyed that. I had a lot of fun ranking the benches. I think it's an amazing thing that we can have so many benches in a rando. I really appreciate all of them. It's been fun adding the benches into randos, and it's something I will always continue to do. Huge shout out to Homothony for putting together the bench rando. It's a lot of benches, 154. Obviously, there aren't actually 154 benches. The Bretta bench isn't actually a bench. You never get God Home Roof in a rando, so I wouldn't count that one either. The Deploy bench, I don't think that actually counts either, so it's more like 150. Gonna wrap it up there. This is so fun to do. It's honestly just a riot, and I got to really think about all these benches. So I hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for watching, everyone, and I will see you next time. Bye.